6 years.
No way.
6 years ago.
No way.
Was the last time I did an unboxing video of a motherboard. But quite frankly, it's also been 6 years since I've had anything that I'm this excited about. ASUS sponsored this unboxing of a handful of their B550 motherboards. And guys, B550 is basically going to be the way to go for, well, until AMD bestows upon us something with even more value than this, which honestly seems kind of far-fetched at this point. Let's start with the Tough Gaming B550M Plus Wi-Fi, which is where I think a lot of B550 buyers are gonna end up because it is quite the sweet spot in terms of value. Accessories wise, you got your Wi-Fi antenna, you got your SATA cable, IO shield, M.2 screws, nothing exciting there. Let's focus on the motherboard itself, starting with the AM4 socket. AMD has done a great job of upholding their commitment to support this socket on a long-term basis, almost to the detriment of their B550 chipset products, because one of the main differentiators between B450, which was their last generation mainstream socket, and B550 was supposed to be support for the upcoming fourth generation Ryzen processors based on their Zen 3 architecture. But then they backtracked, and assuming that your motherboard manufacturer decides to add BIOS support for those chips, you will actually be able to use them, which kind of raises the question, why bother with B550 in the first place, and why does Linus think that this is so important? The reason is that B550 takes almost everything that I would have cared about in an X570 board and ports it down to a lower price point and no requirement for active cooling for the chipset. So what we're looking at here is PCI Express Gen 4 links. So that's double the bandwidth of PCI Express Gen 3 between the CPU and the primary PCI Express 16X graphics slot, as well as one M.2 slot. So you're gonna be able to take advantage of double the bandwidth of PCI Express Gen 3 for both your graphics card and your main storage drive that you've got your OS on for years to come. The other key is that within the constraints of the power delivery design that your motherboard manufacturer implements, there's no limitations on B550 in terms of overclocking, either of the CPU or of the memory. And this is something that I shouldn't have to bring up as a feature, except that Intel recently locked down memory overclocking on some of their SKUs so that you can't get the full potential performance out of those chips. A very unfortunate situation. To illustrate the next big feature, I actually need a different board. This is the B550E from ASUS's ROG Strix lineup. Sorry, B550E Gaming, because it's for gamers. And this puppy right here has got official support, not just for AMD Crossfire, but also NVIDIA SLI, which is something that we haven't seen before on AMD's mainstream Ryzen chipsets, because NVIDIA requires for SLI certification that the 16X slot can be split into an 8X, 8X, rather than having a 16X and a 4X or an 8X and a 4X, as AMD allows for Crossfire support. But Linus, you might say, surely there's gotta be some downside. And there is. X570, which is AMD's higher tier chipset from this generation, has a PCI Express Gen 4x4 link between the CPU and the chipset. So what that means is that Gen 4 devices can be hooked up through the chipset and communicate with the CPU that way. That's how X570 boards can have so many M.2 slots on them, for example. And it also means just generally more bandwidth and more flexibility for motherboard manufacturers when it comes to adding additional features to their boards. So that's why you're gonna see even a high-end B550 board like this one, equipped with only two M.2 slots, one of which is running at Gen 3 speeds, and things like, look at that, we've got a ton of USB 2.0 ports on the back of the I/O plate here. Like, what's the deal with that? Well, the deal with that is that a Gen 3x4 link is just not that fast. So if you wanna add features like in the case of the ROG Strix boards, Intel 2.5 gigabit networking, or in the case of the Tough boards, Realtek 2.5 gig networking, Well, something's gotta give because the user's gonna notice if you go and pile on a whole bunch of onboard features that if they actually go and use all at the same time, you end up with a big nasty bottleneck between the chipset and the CPU socket. None of this is the end of the world, but it does mean that motherboard manufacturers have to make choices. So on this B550 board, for example, ASUS was able to cram more USB 5 gigabit per second ports onto the back panel, but look at this. They had to give up having one of those fancy newfangled USB 3.1 Gen 2 front panel connectors. So if you have a case that has front panel type C, you're gonna have to go with something more like the B550E Gaming. Little things like that. And now that this one has got two USB 3 internal headers, oh boy, well, that's why your back panel is full of USB 2.0 ports. Even this Type-C over here, by the way, is apparently an audio-optimized USB 2. So I guess there's just like, you know, it's like a cleaner circuit for it or something like that. That's something I have not actually seen before. To be clear, I'm not too worried about any of that though. Most of what most of you guys need, the gamers and content creators out there, is high-speed connections between your CPU and your memory, your graphics card, and your storage. And B450 takes care of all of that. And if you really needed some more USB ports, it's not like you can't throw a USB add-in card into one of the PCI Express slots that's available on your board. So really for me, this comes down to which B550 motherboard to go for. What's the right balance of, you know, internal headers versus rear connectors in order for you to be able to plug in everything that you need to? Do you care about something like, you know, more robust VRMs like you might find on a Strix board versus a Prime or a Tough board? Do you care about all the extra RGB headers? This one has four RGB headers. Two of them are 12 volt, two of them are 5 volt addressable. How important is that to you? That's totally on you. But for me, B550 is a totally exciting chipset for what is an exciting generation of chips now, and an even more exciting one with Zen 3 cores just around the corner. So thanks again to ASUS for sponsoring this video. You can find links to their whole B550 lineup, which is quite extensive. They've got a freaking ton of boards. You know, I didn't even get to one of these. This is the B550F Gaming, so this is slightly lower end. You've got no SLI support compared to the E, and I think it drops like that Type-C compatible internal connector or something like that. That seems to be most of the difference. I think might have one fewer RGB connector or something like that. So you can check that out at the link below. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.